Continuing our discussion on integers, we will be discussing two very important concepts called as range of the integer and overflow. Now, I had told you about signed and unsigned integers. For signed integers, one way of representing them is using this bit as the sign bit. But the problem with this signed number representation is 0 is having two representations, one for plus 0 and minus 0, which is actually meaningless. In order to overcome this problem with representing 0, what we do is we utilize an alternative approach called as the 1's complement or the 2's complement method of representing a negative number. So in 2's complement, what happens is, let's say I have number 3 in base 10. So if you see, this is the binary representation of 3 in normal binary system. If I have to represent minus 3, what I have to do is, I have to make the 1 as 0 and 0 as 1. That's what I have done here. To this line, I am going to add 1. So it becomes 1103. This is nothing but minus 3 in 2's complement. Now if I have to bring it back to the original 3, I have to again make 1 as 0 as 0 as 1. So if you see here, it is 0010. Then what I am doing is, I am adding 1 to this. Once I add 1 to this, it becomes 0011, which is nothing but plus 3 in base 10. So this method of 2's complement is used for representing negative numbers. In the 2's complement, you will see that the negative number, the lastmost bit will generally be, in fact, will always be 1. Now there is another terminology you need to understand, something called as the range. I had briefly told you in the previous integer discussion, but I'll just give you a refresher on that. Suppose I have an integer whose width is only 8 bits. So what is its range? If it can only store positive numbers, or if it is an unsigned int, it can store from 0 to 255. That is 2 raised to n minus 1. So its range is 0 to 255. But suppose that 8 bits itself I'm using to store both positive and negative numbers, then it can store only between minus 128 to plus 127. In both the cases, it's storing 256 numbers, but here it is storing both negative and positive. For a signed 8 bit, to find its range, this is the formula: minus 2 n minus 1 2 plus 2 n minus 1 minus 1. Now this explains a lot about what a range of an integer is. Now let's assume we have an unsigned int of 8 bits. So the minimum number is 0, the maximum number is 255. So if I represent 255 in a binary system and if I add 1 to it, you will see that it ends up becoming 0. So for an unsigned number, when I add 1 to 255 in an 8-bit representation, it's pushed and it becomes 0. And again it continues in this endless cycle. If I add 256 to 0, it is again going to come back to 0. Or if I add 1 to 255, it's going to be to 0. If I make 254 plus 2, it's again going to be equal to 0. Assuming it's an 8-bit integer, just a theoretical concept. Now, this is okay if it is an unsigned integer. But the problem you will have is, if you have a signed, suppose instead of signed integer, unsigned integer, if it was signed, then you are not going to get these kind of results. The result is going to vary from compiler to compiler and from hardware machine to machine. You will know more about that when we try to solve certain concept clearing problems ahead. The moral of the story is, unsigned integer, no problem. If you push it after 255 or the maximum limit by 1, it will become 0. But for signed, if you push it on some machines, it may become 0. Some machines, it may become something else. So with signed integers, be very careful how you handle the overflow. So when I push 255 by 1, it basically overflows, or its capacity goes beyond. That is known as the overflow. And this is somewhere where C is not really great. It doesn't really warn you when there is an overflow or the underflow. The program will invariably crash. So it is your job to keep track of what is the limit or what is the range of number the program is working on. If it goes beyond a certain range, your code is going to create trouble during runtime. In fact, there have been space shuttles which have crashed because of this kind of errors.